it seems to have always been that way, and I'm just finding this very interesting. I've been following this along to see what needs to be discussed within my commission, that if we can have any input or recommendations, but knowing that it is the actual size of the sign which is controlled by the zoning commission.
Cliff Hacken, Westwood Road. You invited me back to make a statement from...
And I really appreciate you being here.
I printed this out from the Merriam-Webster Dictionary. Sign definition, something material or external that stands for or signifies something spiritual. Now, I'm just going to ask you this. Here's something spiritual, Santa Claus. I'm wondering if you would allow a sign like this to be placed on someone's lawn. It's about 20 feet. Okay.
That's a really good question for us to ponder when we get to discuss this. Okay. Can I keep this?
Oh, certainly can.
Thank you very much.
And here's the definition. You could also, I'd like to respond to that young lady there from the...
But you're going to do that through the chair.
Okay. And if you don't like billboards, you can always go to the socialist state of Vermont. They don't allow billboards. I'd like to also mention if, and this is a good recommendation, you should allow political signs 6 weeks prior to an election, and they have to be down 1 week after an election. It doesn't make any difference if the election's in November, December, June, April, or May. And I think that would be a very good response to the people who have a question about political signs. But if they're not allowed to be more than 12 square feet per property, this sign of Woodbury in the back of you, the zoning map, is almost 12 square feet. So to have that one little sign like that on someone's property is a little bit ridiculous. If you don't allow something bigger than that, I have to give you a quote which I gave last time, the quote from Ayn Rand. We are fast approaching the stage of the ultimate inversion, the stage where the government is free to do anything it pleases, but the citizens may act only by permission, and this stage is the darkest one in human history, the stage of rule by brute force. Thank you.
Point of clarification, I think, Cliff.
Yes.
Although most people relate political signs to elections, they don't have to be. So if you're a citizen who's opposed to the war in Iraq, right, you might want to put up a sign that says, right, stay out of Iraq. I mean, that would not fall into your 6 weeks prior.
Correct.
Thank you very much for your comment.
Thank you.
James Sandu, the Old Town Farm Road. As I understand it, you're keeping this public hearing open until your next meeting. Will you take public input at that point?
Yes.
Okay.
And I have to ask this commission to vote on an extension. I can't assume it.
Okay. And then after that, assuming you make some changes, will you send it back to the Planning Commission?
I'm going to give you the same answer that I gave Bill, which is if this commission determines that they are sufficiently substantive changes that they warrant to be referred back, then the answer is yes. But if this commission does not make substantive changes, maybe semantics or context changes, this commission may decide that they're insubstantive and do not have to be referred back to planning.
But then
it's
they up to would this have commission to have decide. A 4-1 vote, or four. More than a 3-2 vote.
Jen, I am hoping when we're done it will be a 5-0 vote.
I'm sure you are, Martin. I'm just saying, with the decision of the Planning Commission and their recommendations, that would preclude just the majority vote.
If the Zoning Commission, we're alluding to statute, where the Zoning Commission wishes to override the Planning Commission, which it has the authority to do, must be done by at least a 2/3 majority vote. Right, you're right. We understand.
Okay.
Duncan. And then Adele.
I'm going to give you another picture. This is the signs in front of the town hall of city property. The signs that the Planning Commission, the Zoning Commission, the town workers all come in. There's more than one sign here.
Thank you.
I also noticed that those signs are not behind the sidewalk, which the state requires. The town just seems to exempt itself from stuff. I have one last comment from you. I think that you are getting into something that you haven't really explored and talked about to the public, and it is substantial, and you have a lot more problems. You have the floodplain, where the town spent $17,000 on a tennis court, which was going to be below water, and the selectman at that time was told prior to spending the $17,000 that flooded. And he hadn't been here long enough to see it then. I had. Here's the signs down at Route 6 on one piece of property, all on state property. If you guys don't think you have enough to do, you let the town fathers build a brick wall without going to the historic district, visible from the road, where those of us that are in the historic district,
Duncan,
have applied for addition.
Duncan, it's going to help this commission and the members of the public here if you restrict your comments to the changes to the zoning regulations.
Well, the change of the zoning, I'm saying that you are doing stuff. You can't even take care of what you have, and you're trying to change things. And that is appropriate. The dog food place, the dog kennel down there, wasn't supposed to have semi-trailer trucks.
Can you help me out here? Because if I put this in the record, I need...
That's the old town hall.
But this...
This is
I'm trying to track with you, Duncan. I'm really trying to track with you. Yeah. I think you said that this was built without a permit.
Right.
What's that got to do with the regulation changes? Please.
It's a zoning permit? Didn't have a zoning permit to put a stone wall which was visible from the state highway.
A zoning permit?
Yes.
There was a permit.
But not to put the stone wall in. And not to drain the
water. You're on the building committee, right?
It was all...
But I don't want... The point is, Duncan, I'm sorry, but I have to disagree with you that this has got anything to do with the regulation changes. Do you want to take this one back? Fight that battle another day, Duncan.
Here's a picture of the San Ramos building as it was. It was added on to. I'm saying you guys have got too much on your carpet to start another fight, and that's what you're looking for. You let this building get expanded, you double, triple the size of the parking lot on it. And the zoning office was informed that they were tearing up the grass behind the building to expand the parking lot. And you, and I speak that in reference to an older board, because your chairman refers to older boards all the time, made me have a certain percentage of my land covered with building and open space. San Ramos covers about 78% to 80% of the land with parking lot and building. Good program. If you're going to try and trash Main Street, don't worry about a few signs that stay up for a few weeks.
So can you speak to this particular picture before we put it in the record?
That's the semi-trailer truck that wasn't supposed to be delivered on Main Street in the dog park.
But it's nothing to do with signs.
Well, that's a pretty big sign. It says Napoli on the side of the truck. Okay. All right? I mean, you can't handle what you got right now.
No, I get it.
You're not enforcing your own regulations. Nice piece of work. You talk about somebody... about decorating the town of Woodbury, that was a nice job. Then you guys spent thousands of dollars on designs for, that's the inland wetlands walking up to put a new highway department, all right? Thousands of dollars on drawings. Here's what you did with the school. I had to go down and complain and say, let's do something about it. Okay? Parking cars all over Middle Road Turnpike. Trash in Middle Road Turnpike.
I'm going to keep trying to bring you back to the specific thing.
Bring you back. Here's more. This will bring you all back. This is the river where our town planner lived on the corner of it. Watch the beavers knock down all the trees, let them stay there, so when it flooded, guess what? It ran up against the bank. That's the town planner, which impacted these regulations substantially. Good planning. Not even thinking what he was doing. You guys turned down the...
Leave it to the beaver.
They turned down the telecommunications thing behind the town hall here. Said it wasn't right. All right? Probably could have paid for the recreation department in its entirety and nobody could see it. You think you've done your job? You haven't started to do your job.
the telephone poles going down Middle Road Turnpike.